Tesla is replacing robots at Giga Berlin by aluminium casting machines. Yesterday, I reported that Tesla is going to use 8 huge 100-ton Giga Presses at Giga Berlin casting machines, but we didn't realize at that time that this means replacing a lot of robots by casting machines. You know Tesla's obsession and automotive world's obsession by using robots. But now looks like robots are going to be moving over, because this is the time for huge 100-ton strong casting machines. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from torquenews.com. If you would like to receive daily Tesla news, please subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you don't miss my next Tesla story. Edward Taylor and Paul Linert are reporting a very interesting details on this subject at Reuters, saying robots are not efficient enough for Tesla's new car factory at Giga Berlin, which plans to replace hundreds of robots with giant aluminum casting machines to build simpler chassis parts, a person familiar with the matter told Reuters. So hundreds of robots are going to be gone. The electric car maker Tesla has in the past struggled to raise production volumes through high-tech automation and was forced to fly in a new production line from Germany to Nevada in 2018 after robots failed to coordinate seamlessly at the US factory, writes Reuters. Reuters also reports that for the new Model Y, Tesla chief executive Elon Musk has said he will replace 70 components glued and riveted into the car's rear unit underbody with a single module made using an aluminum casting machine. So we're talking about 70 components being gone using only one single part in the through the casting machine. This means at least 70 robots will be gone, or maybe 100 robots, because we're talking about hundreds of robots. That means 2-3 robots doing one particular work. That's just the start of the automation drive, with the vehicle's front module and other parts to come, the sources said. So in the future, who knows how many thousands of robots will be gone from Giga Berlin and eventually from other Tesla factories, Fremont, Giga Shanghai, and who knows, maybe we will see fewer and fewer robots at Giga Texas, which is being built right now. Will be amazing to see it in operation. Biggest casting machine ever made. Will make rare body in a single piece, including crash rails, Musk said on Twitter on August 13th, if you remember. He also did not say where or when the new machine would be rolled out. But we know that these casting machines are made in Italy by Idra company, and we know that they're going to start coming to Giga Berlin. Tesla did not respond to requests for comment from Reuters reports. Tesmanian, our friend, a blog specializing in Tesla news, said on Monday the company's new plant in Brandenburg near Berlin would be supplied with 8 Giga Press machines. And we also said this was also written in the thousands of pages information that was revealed by Tesla online. And as you know, our German friends who always report Tesla news had also deciphered some of them. I posted them link in the description of yesterday's video. You can peruse it. And also that Tesla Mag, a German Tesla news company, a news website, also had the details of this information that Tesla will use a 8 Giga Presses at Giga Berlin. Car bodies have traditionally been made by assembling multiple stamped metal panels, which has helped car makers to design crumple zones to absorb energy during a crash, but Elon Musk is charting a new course at the Brandenburg plant. Here's the pros and cons. Car bodies have traditionally, like I said, been made by assembling multiple stamped metals. The pros of this is that, you know, if God forbid there is a crash or there is a accident, you know, one part or two part or three parts are damaged, you can just change them in a less expensive way. But now when you are making that whole multiple assembly parts into one part, God forbid if there is a accident or something like that, then you have to change the whole thing. Or how is this going to work, especially in the future? If Tesla is going to make the front like that too, you may have to change the entire body of the car if there is a crash. But the pros is that it will make building a car much cheaper, and the price of the car should drop, especially when the battery price also drops as well. He wants the car body to be made from modules, as few of them as possible, the source explained to Reuters. He sees casting as the new way forward, like casting a toy car of metal. That source also told Reuters, published in the Reuters article, which I will have the description in the link in the description of this video. Reuters also says that the Giga Press, which is the size of a small house, that's how big they are, each of them is like 100 tons, will be supplied by Italy's Idra SRL and forms a key part with Elon Musk drives to reinvent the machine that builds the machine, the source added to Reuters. Idra declined to comment to Reuters as well. Reuters says Idra has previously said it has supplied its first ever Giga Press to a North American auto manufacturer without naming it. And we know that there is a Giga Press already, I believe, in use in Fremont, and also there is one in use in Giga Shanghai, but Giga Berlin Giga Factory will have 8 of them. Imagine how big it is, and I don't know how many Giga Presses, that those huge casting machines, Giga Texas will have. Reuters continues that Elon Musk's push to reduce manufacturing complexity comes as German car makers BMW, Mercedes, and Audi face pressure from their workers to preserve domestic assembly jobs, which are under threat as regulators push electric cars that have fewer components and combustion engined ones. They have fewer components than the cars with combustion engine has, so that may affect some jobs. Aluminium has proven cumbersome to use in large components because it is difficult to stamp into complex shapes, explains Reuters, and continues saying, to get intricate ridges and other shapes, aluminium pieces have needed to be glued or riveted since welding deforms the metal. Injecting molten aluminium into a cast and having robots pull out the molded metal allows Tesla to combine several manufacturing steps. Reuters also goes on explaining that Sandy Munro, chief executive officer of manufacturing consulting firm Munro and Associates, and a previous critic of some of Tesla's manufacturing processes, lauded its improvement, saying that this apparently saying, we were very critical of Tesla when we first started on their vehicles, Sandra Munro said, and says that the gaps were horrific, the weld spatter was everywhere, nothing fit, Munro said during a recent presentation with consultants Frost and Sullivan, but the switch from the Model 3 to a larger vehicle, the Model Y, resulted in a step change in manufacturing improvements, Munro said. Reuters also concluded saying that Tesla has already reduced the rear underbody to 2 parts, forming the largest piece of aluminum that Munro has seen in 30 years of analyzing components. This is the biggest casting we have seen in car company. This is just spectacular, Munro said, Reuters report. But we're seeing also in Germany, elsewhere, companies also moving toward electrification. Last week, when Elon Musk was in Germany, we saw that he test drove with Volkswagen's chairman of the board, Herbert Diess, the new ID3, and he kind of was very positive about ID3. And today, this morning, Volkswagen's Herbert Diess released a picture saying that he also test drove Tesla's Model Y and called it a reference. So Volkswagen is one of the champions of German automotive industry that has gone past the diesel gate toward electrification. And I think Mercedes and BMW are also making solid efforts toward electrification. We will see how things go. So, well, friends, this is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news. And you can see the reference of Reuters article in the description of this video. We are still looking for and hiring Tesla reporters. If anybody would like to write daily Tesla stories and be paid at TorqueNews.com, please contact me using the email found in the about page of our Torque News YouTube channel. And in the meantime, have a wonderful rest of the day. God bless you. Take good care of each other, and see you soon in our next report.